Hello and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 Geheimnisnacht with the Warhammer mod and of course the Realm of Pleasure. So I don't actually know what I planned to do last episode. That's always good. I think we've conquered these territories, but the truth with this guy is like really short, so we could just declare another war against him. I don't really want this territory back here, nor this one right now. But yeah, this kingdom, for example, oh, not really. Yeah, this is a kingdom. These steps would be pretty good. But I think I'm going for this because I think that there is a holy place in there. Wait. Turkan. And what is this? Down here. Yeah, but Turkan is a holy place of Slaanesh, is it not? It is, but why is it not under my control then? Oh, wait. This guy is Slaanesh. Yeah. What are you talking about? Also, this guy apparently wants independence and this guy is supporting him. Oh, the kings that I've slaughtered the father of, I think. Oh, not only that, I sucked their relative's soul, so yeah, they're kind of mad at me about that. But that doesn't really bother me at all. Karkarit. You know what? This is not Karkarit. Where is Karkarit? It says it is right. Is it this? It is this? It doesn't tell me if it's a holy site of Slaanesh. It says Carthul, but up here it says Karkarit. Chiefdom of Karkarit is a holy site. Where is this chiefdom of Karkarit? Over here. Oh. That is far away. And Zenbijin, of course, is over here. That is the capital province of this kingdom, I believe. It is not... Yeah, it is the kingdom capital. Obviously, the kingdom is actually called Zenbijin. I wonder, will we just go and conquer that real quick? Certainly have the troops nearby. I mean, we can recruit a lot of troops down here. Could also concentrate some of our southern forces to attack, well, the south. While we still need to convert this guy. Or his son. That makes me consider, for example, I can just say, hey, you. Beastie boy. Be my pupil. I'm going to take you as ward, and I think I can take you as an acolyte. And that should convert you. For example, this is the way we converted this fool. And he has a son, and he's also Slaanesh, so that's very good. Yeah, that's how we're going to do it. He actually just declared a war. Attacking Grandmaster Pierre the Blessed against a holy war for Adrian. I don't know if I want to... You actually took territories up here already. Interesting. But Adrian is... where is Adrian? Sounds like it's over here because you attack this fool. Grandmaster Pierre. But I don't think you're gonna win against him. He has 10,000 men. Oh, you do have 10,000 men yourself. But I want someone else to rule the kingdom of Paraskoros. So maybe we should conquer these territories now. Declare a war against this guy. We're just going to make it a conquest because I don't think he actually has any other titles. So, there we go. Conquest of this title. It's going to be a conquest of... Oh, you are Pavona. So maybe I don't want to attack you right now just because it would be annoying. Then we're going to declare a conquest of this province. And I think this is territory of Pierre. And then we have this guy of the Broska Federation. And we're just going to... I could just declare a holy war for Saloniki, which I'm going to do. My vassals would decline against most of these people, but if I just call you in for... I don't need to seduce you, you are my lover already. No, you are not. Who's my lover at the moment? The King of Netherland and the King of you are already my lover. You are my kinswoman and you are my kinsman, which is good. Yeah, you are already my lover. I don't know why I can Is there another king down here? Who are you? Wait. Who did I just click on? Oh! This guy is actually... he's of a revolt, and he's not actually one of my vassals. So I don't care about him. Why don't we try to seduce... he's always in wars. How about the Emperor? He's also always in wars, but let's try to seduce him. Just because. So if I call this guy in, it's 4,000 men. For example, he's not going to go with our... Oh, he's not going to join any of these wars. I see. Well, it doesn't really matter. We are going to declare the war in the north, for sure, against these guys. It's going to be a little bit messy to control all of these, but it is going to be fine. So Zhenbejin is going to what I want. Going to get these troops and just move them over there. Going to get some more troops from the surrounding kingdoms. And they're just going to march up there. I'm not going to send them on boat or anything. 20,000 men. Probably lose like half of them. On the way up north, but it is fine. Of course, I didn't declare any war against Reichland, which I did want to do, but oh well. Can't have everything, I suppose. I am going to send most of these troops on the fleets. So that I can deploy them quicker down here. I don't think I need to take care of much of the war in the north. I don't know if these are going to be enough troops. Do I have anything close by? Not really. But let's get the Middenland troops. And with Middenland, I of course mean Westerheim. Could also get the Middenheim troops. Send them over. Can't call in this guy, of course. Let's get some more troops from you. Maybe from you as well. Oh wow, that's a lot of troops. Yeah, sure. How about your troops from Norskvek? Norskvek is one of my strongest provinces. I forgot I used these troops in the war against the dwarves just. That's why they're most likely all dead at the moment. Well, we're going to form up our armies up north there. And our other armies form up right here. And... yeah, he's going to get some holy orders, but I don't really care about that too much. 8,000 men. They're going to fall into Arcais and then into Hinrichnes, which we will conquer easily. I don't know how many troops this guy has. 4,000? That's nothing against our glorious hordes. And this goblin horde is not going to change anything. Get some commanders working for us here. Send the fleet back home. Let's look at up north. Our armies are forming up, which is perfect. There are going to be some more reinforcements. The other armies are marching. Marching? I'm marching north. And yeah, we should activate our reinforcements here. That is too expensive. We can only reinforce them halfly, but even that is going to cost us. We don't actually get that much money. So right now I can't really get the attention of my target here, but that is only because he's in a war against someone. He's always in a war. Right now he's declaring, leading a war against Baron Laurent of Kelheim. Don't know where that is. Still don't know where that is. Oh, it is just a small barony down here. And there it goes. Okay, so let's see. Maybe he is not going to lead his troops now that the war is over. Now he's still leading the troops. He has some rebellions going on, I think. No, these are not rebellions. These are just raiders. So he might settle now that the war's over. Okay, this is more likely an army that I will need down there. So, send them down. And they're just going to take care of this up here. The holy war there. Of course, the territories themselves are not really concerning. These armies, on the other hand, are. These are 20,000 men. Let's form them up right here. Because I want to attack this army. The Queen Leah of Nordland, the wife of my lover Grand Baron Henneken, shocked me by asking me to my face if we're having an affair. I will just deny. She accused me last episode already, and I didn't kill her there. I didn't want to get wounded. That's not good. There's no rush. Yeah, once he's going to settle down at some point. I'm sure of it. Okay, now that they're just going to besiege this. There's no rush. Truly, there is not. Okay, so you are going to march against these guys. They have 10,000 troops, and they have very strong knights. Oh, there they are. So yeah, they have special units, and you are attacking them. Wow, that is brave of you. Maybe a little bit dumb. My friend Alwyn has a tender and loving soul, trusting everyone in the castle. I fear he will get hurt someday. His apprentice, monstrous, minor, tender soul. I will give him a tender back. Yes, please. Well, I don't know if kindness is good for Slanesh, but envy is good. So I suppose kindness is not good. Would be the automatic conclusion to that. I don't like that we have to march all the way around. But the fleet here is just too small. Yeah, no, these fleets are not going to carry these men. So let them march. Let the men march. Might lose this army up in the north. See if I care. My second army should come in any second now. We won the Siege of Belgrade. Don't even know where the Siege of Belgrade is. But thankfully we have castles everywhere, so they need to besiege these. I don't know when they formed, to be honest. We have some tribes everywhere still. We have won the war against the Goblin Horde, which is not very surprising. Considering they are just goblins. Filthy bastards. Okay, so this is just heavy cavalry. And, well, I say just with a little bit of caution, because heavy cavalry is deadly, but there are no horse archers, so that's pretty good. These are also just light infantry. Charge them, really? I don't need 20,000 men to take out 1,000 light infantry and some archers. Okay, there's a... that's actually really bad for them, because there was an army stationed here where they went to rebel. Okay, there's no rush. He's not that far away, and he's no longer leading troops, so we'll find a way to seduce this old man, even though he's young in my standard. That is because nearly everyone that is currently alive is young compared to me. Yeah, the cavalry here is actually destroying us, so that is just what I expected. That's right. She's proud. Oh, that's pretty good. That is pretty good. You go north. Why do I... I've inherited something, I think. Because these troops... The Realm of Pleasure, Koros Company. Let's send them back. I don't know what they are. They're special units. Spell points. Oh, did he... Oh, he casted a spell. Let's not click on them and dispel them, because they're actually his. Is he going to win this battle? Okay, let's actually dispel them, because they are annoying me quite a lot. No, he's not winning it, like I thought. He might have won it with the spell that was for some reason given to me, that he casted, but oh well. I actually don't want him to succeed. So there's that. So yeah, we lost this battle in the north, but we won the other one. I think winter just hit, because we are losing men everywhere. You have inherited the kingdom of Bertliskisk, but you love me because of my long reign, so that's pretty nice. If only these guys would actually, you know, I don't know why he's still... I assume at this point it's his culture. Also, where's my court priest at the moment? You need to convert this province still. No, this province is converted. What are you talking about? I don't understand why these guys are not turning feudal. Would be very kind of them. There is no rush. And there will never be one. Got some technology we can invest in. It is cultural technology. We already have the noble customs, so let's go with the popular customs and religious. Why not? If we can, get them all. Get all the customs. It's not like people hate us at this point. Like, everyone loves us. So. We're just going to attack this quickly. And we should win this war rather easily. It's a holy war even, so he's not going to be vassalized by us. Which is nice. Can give these titles to anyone we want. There's going to be some... Ah, he casted a spell again. This is weird. First of all, they should not be given to me. Secondly, I don't know why... Well, nowhere where I click, it's just selecting them for some reason. Having many lovers is exciting and fulfilling. So much love, so much desire, but so little time. I feel like I'm burning the candle at both ends. I can make this work. I don't care about stressed. Yes, the winds of chaos will... Why are you the leader of a revolt? Your son is revolting against... Oh god damn, these spell units are annoying me. The winds of chaos will favor only the chosen ones of the gods. To prepare Alvin, he must give in to Sanish and his unholy worship and live by his tenets. All the same, he needs to learn... Yeah, I'll speak of him to Sanish. Alvin has finally felt Sanish's touch and yearns for more. Aware of the uncharted heights of pleasure he still has to reach. Very good. But why are you rebelling? And you dead. You were slain in personal combat. What? How? This guy should not have even... What is going on? First of all, I think I have chosen the wrong child to begin with because this guy was a rebel. Secondly, I don't know what's going on. He should have not been in a battle. I don't know why he was slain. You surrender. So these titles are now mine. You still have a title somewhere? The first Kalk Halberdier. Duchy of Sirkoni. What? No, oh yeah, the duchy. What else do you hold? The Northern Boron Confederacy, the Eagle Confederacy, and the Kingdom of Bosca Confederacy. Really? It is only this title that you hold. You don't have any landed titles over, so I don't really care about you. Maybe I should've. Yeah, I should've actually subjugated him. But oh well. What is done is done. Matters not anymore. We are going to get the Duchy of Saloniki here. And we're going to create a new castle vassal, if I find a castle. There's one, but this one is not mine for some reason. So we just need to create a new call a couple of priests to my court. There's the one. This is a good priest. He has a long beard and he has strong blue eyes. He's going to be a good king down here. He's going to get the Yoldom of Tusalan, and he's going to be a mighty ruler indeed. I finally reached my vassal limit. I can't really do anything against that. It's going to be there forever. Ah, he's in a new war, damn it. He's always leading his troops personally, which is very bad for my love interest in him. I wish he would not do that. Okay, we're going to crush this army and probably just win. There's no rush. Okay, we are actually helping our vassals fight these guys off. It shouldn't really care who's leading this. Oh, maybe it did. Well, let's march up north and take out this guy. We are winning this war anyways. Might as well fight against the other one. You have done something in my capital. Nice. No rush. Speaking of my capital, we should upgrade it further. How about we go with a warrior tribunal? That seems nice. And soon the whole of the Border Princes will be under our control, which is also a very nice thing to look forward to. We're just going to subjugate this guy. I don't think we are going to subjugate him personally, because his main title is the... You know, the order. We gain the county over here. Very nice. Goddamn spell units! Yeah. You're going to get the chiefdom of Ilska. Is Ilska? No. No, don't give him Ilska. This is Hyrnikus. Ilska is one of mine. Hyrnikus. Or Hinrikus. That is what you get. Not my title. That would be bad. Oh, this is good. Whatever happened over here. Oh no, it's still Pervona. I don't know what exactly happened that it changed its color, but... Oh well. It's a pretty strong castle. Are these castles equally strong? Maybe not, because they lose a lot of their buildings when I take them over. Okay, we're just going to assault it. Otherwise the siege would take forever. Wow, these garrison forces are out of control. So yeah, if I die, the Empire will surely break apart. Not only because I lose a lot of titles. We do have a lot of people. I'm going to keep the Empire, that is a good thing. But sadly I'm not going to keep the Kingdom, because it has a different succession law at the moment. But I don't really plan on dying anytime soon. I am a demon, or daemon, after all. You know what I totally forgot about? The war in the north. Okay, let's see. I can create this kingdom, duchy, but I cannot create the kingdom of Paris yet. I'm going to give you the duchy. The duchy of the Yorkdom of Griekland. But yeah, totally. How many troops have died from attrition? Not that many, actually. But yeah, I totally forgot this this war. Need to split our troops up so that they conquered all this territory and that we just win this war from conquering everything. Should be easy enough. There's no rush. Let us build forts, so that we don't have to hold our armies in these provinces. And I think that is pretty much all of the kingdom that I'm conquering currently. So after that we can just move north, take out his army. Still no rush. Yeah. The forts are not yet constructed, but very soon they will be. And I think... I can't say that I've driven out all the other chaos worshippers in the world, but if I take out these Nurglites, then I am going to be the only major chaos, well, faction around. We still have a couple of, you know, chaos people in the Empire, and maybe even down here. Like, no, this is an orc. Maybe you are a chaos follower? No. Could have tried to seduce this guy. And maybe, yeah, let's actually try that. Maybe we can stop this seduction with this guy. Maybe we can convert his kingdom. Seduce Benito. But he's such a little morsel. Marcel. Okay, so the Empire is just a mess. Oh, look over here. This guy is a Nurglite. But yeah, the Empire is a mess that I don't really care about. Even with only 4,000 men, we are suffering attrition. That is so unforgiving, really brutal. But these are the Chaos Wastes. Don't actually expect any mercy up here. Sadly, I know that the that the attrition is not really better anywhere else in the world, sadly. Which of course is a problem. These guys, they do have some riders, but not enough to stop me for long. So let's take over this castle and the city. Unite our armies of 14,000 men. We're going to get the organizer to lead the army. We're going to get the holy warrior on our left, right flank, and we're going to get this guy on the left flank. Send our armies forth. Of course, need a new commander from time to time. This guy's a flanker, that's a good choice always. The organizer is going to make us suffer less attrition, and he's going to make us move quicker, so that's nice. I watched my ward, Magarith, at play with another child yesterday and noticed that she didn't want to share her toys. She needs to lecture on charity now. She needs to birch. This is how children learn thrift. Yes. Be greedy, you little bitch. A Zikmar riot revolt somewhere. Not that I care. These little fools cannot withstand the power of chaos. May they try what they want. So, funnily enough, the north of Kislev has been nearly completely converted. Not, well, most of Norskwa, but there are a couple of chaos undivided provinces still left. And we even have some provinces in Norskwa that are not under our control. This one actually is not under our control yet. Funnily enough. And we don't control this one. We've never bothered to take this island. I should probably do that at some point. On this island. Which are the same kingdom. I never bothered. I could. Easily, obviously. But I had no reason. Actually, I just forgot about them, honestly. Until right now. There's no other reason behind that. What is over here? The Koldmire. So this war is nearly won. I will teach him the tenets of... Oh, he's wounded now. He's actually dead, which is even worse. Could you not be my apprentice then? That is a bit odd. I don't want to teach a dead child how to cast magic. That seems like a very dangerous thing to do and very reckless. So we're going to crush his army. That's going to give us some war scores, sadly only. We're going to march north and take over these two tribes. Oh, you know what? You know what? Mate, this guy actually moved an army over here. And he dared retake his capital. No, not his capital, but his province. So we're going to go over here. We're going to show this army who's what's worth. And, well, we're going to crush him, obviously. So our next war will be against the Order of the Lily. It's actually the Knights of the Lily, not the Order. This guy is 200% a Nurglite. He's maimed, he's possessed, he has rattle lung, he has crutz, he's incapable, and he is already 200 years old. Why is no one, like, thinking, not only is this guy surviving very deadly illnesses and diseases, he also has done so for the past 200 years. Something can't be right with this guy. I mean, of course, the lady grants her followers many favors, and longevity is surely one of them. For example, this guy is King Renaud the Weak, is, I don't think, a Chaos follower. He's also mad, but his longevity actually comes from the Grail Knight. Which might explain his one down here as well. But he should probably succumb to those illnesses and diseases. The lady can only do so much for her followers, I think. So He's just standing there and awaiting me. Which is somewhat frightening me, but we outnumber them 1-3, more or less. Not exactly, but nearly. And even his horse archers are not going to save him from the swords and shields of the Chaos, Raiders, Marauders, and Knights. We probably have beastmen in our ranks at this point. Maybe even before. Like, we probably had a lot of beastmen just in our ranks and following me around. Because that is how Chaos works. It would be foolish to think that our armies are fully human. We probably have some Forsaken, Chaos Spawn, very mutated creatures. Our armies... Well, we are Norskin and not Chaos Waste people. Or we were Norskin, but yeah, our armies are vast and... vast and furious. Okay, so please accept my peace offer. It is very generous of me to already say that I want peace with you. Because, well, I should just crush you. Let's go and destroy this tribe because he dared march against me. Which I'm not happy about. It is something he should not have dared. You're just fighting some wars right now. I don't really mind. There is no rush to our love. I just wonder how that works. Like, am I just going to show up in his bedroom one day and be like, we're gonna make some love now? And it's not like he has the choice. Like, if she's probably tall, like 2.5 meters tall or something, maybe taller, like 3 meters or something. And when she demands to make love with you, I don't think you'll say no. First of all, she has horns, she's very big, she probably has more reproductive organs than any man or woman ever could hope for. She probably has 4 arms, I think that is pretty much... Yeah, that seems right. And then again, she's not a demonette, she's a demon prince, so... I don't actually know, they probably look different than demonettes. Oh, now that I think about it, they'd probably look a lot different. But she's still a demon. And she's a higher demon. She's a demon prince. That's even worse than a demonette. So... Yeah, only God knows, only Slaanesh knows what she looks like and... Well, probably wouldn't refuse such a creature. Just because of fear, really. Then again, you quite literally cannot refuse her. Because it's not like you could, you know, fight her or anything. I don't know why I've started this discussion and I'm talking about it with such a zeal. But yeah, the war is over, finally. And we're going to accept our demands here. No, we're going to enforce our demands. He's going to accept our demands. We finally have taken over this title. This holy site is under your control. So, our moral authority has risen once again. We are going to usurp the Tarkanet of Zanbaijin, which is only the Yogdom, but it's also the kingdom at the same time. And we are going to... Didn't I have some priests in my court? Not all of them are used, but let's just create some new because I don't know where they are. This guy is also a bearded man, manly man. I want you to get the Gyurkdom and then you get the kingdom. Can't give you the kingdom, huh? Why is that? The Royal Laws of Zanbaijin. Oh, you're a tribal bastard. That explains it. It's no rush. Yeah, that's kind of bad. Not really, though. Tribal bastard. I have very little respect to most of my subjects, which I don't really need to have, because, you know, either they respect me or I'm going to suck out their soul, and I can tell you that I'm going to enjoy that. I don't know why I'm still trying to kill her, it never worked out. We'll have to kill this guy. Because for some reason he's like, oh... He wants this Yogdom. But he's not going to get it. He's actually very weak in comparison. I don't know why you are not enforcing your claim. You know what, you only have a weak claim. So if I kill this guy, then you can enforce your weak claim. I wanted to end the episode already, but right now I want to continue, just see what happens if he actually presses his claim. In the meantime, we're going to build a medium war mammoth pent. I'm playing a lot of Total War in the moment, Warhammer. I really enjoyed a good Bretonnia campaign there. And I just noticed now that sadly the Norskans don't really have any Orbeez. For example, the War Mammoths. That would be great. Great. I'm not talking about Chaos, but the Norskan tribes. With their Marauders and all. I also wish I could play as them. As the Norskan tribes. I also would like to play as Krakar Drak, for example. The challenge would be insane. But I can imagine that it would be a lot of fun to, you know. The Krakar Drak is this, by the way. This dwarfdom here. And, well, you start surrounded by Norskan tribes and chaos right at your door, so. So I killed him. But my complicity was discovered. As is expected. So you could now press your claim. Oh, he died. That is sad. Yeah, well, there are more fish. For example, his heir. Could offer him vassalization. He's like, oh, you are of the false religion. And also a bit too far away. So such a little morsel. You want to spread warp dust in Trollheim. What? Blessings upon you and your house. We would like you to back our plot to spread warp dust in Trollheim. Why would you... Don't spread warp dust in my province. What are you on about? Decline! Well, I know about his plot now. Let me... I don't want your warp dust in my province. You bastard. Get lost. And you want to hunt me down? Wow, that is rude of you. Obviously, I'm going to ask him to stop that, please. He also doesn't really like me too much. Long rain, that he likes. The harsh feudal text he's not so happy about. So a zealous man, and I'm an infidel, apparently. Well, technically, you are the infidel. But I'm going to send you 20 gold, and now you like me a lot more. I am going to end the episode here. I thank you all for watching. And if you enjoyed, then consider leaving a like and a comment down below. And we will see us in the next episode. Until then, take care. Bye.